are making egg rolls. We're going to make the fillings, and then we're going to show you how to wrap it. And we're also making sweet and sour sauce.
I have my wok preheated on high heat, and I just made my meat mixture. It's the dry cornstarch. Sure. I have black pepper, soy sauce, and brown sugar. And you just want to mix it all fat in my wok.
What are you trying to achieve now at this point?
I'm going to not burn it. I just want to break it up into small pieces.
What he's missing here, because it's sticking like that, there should have been oil to the pan. That was the first step. Preheat the pan, oil in it, then the meat. And so you wonder why is it sticking? Why is it? It's because there's hardly any fat in that ground turkey. Thank you, because we're doing the body good. Traditionally, it's made with ground pork. You can use ground beef if you want. If you're vegetarians, you could just eliminate the meat altogether. So he wants to chop it up into small pieces. Let's start the sweet and sour sauce. What kind of ingredients are in the sweet and sour sauce?
Really simple sweet and sour sauce. Just going down the list, it's some rice wine vinegar, some soy sauce, some pineapple juice, brown sugar, normal sugar, and then ketchup and optional red chili flakes.
Okay, Dakota?
So what we did, we just added everything right into the omelet pan, and we're just going to bring it to a boil. Don't add your cornstarch slurry. That's, and carrot, one by one, the onions.
Yeah, these are beautifully cut, finely chopped carrots, and minced onions.
Then the garlic. Ginger. I mix that together.
Okay.
And then I want to add the celery, mushrooms, and bean sprouts.
Napa cabbage and green onions. Everything looks beautifully prepped. So the only thing you have left is the cornstarch slurry. And there's important steps that they should remember before using cornstarch slurry, which is mixing it up beforehand because the cornstarch sinks to the bottom.
So you're just gonna slowly mix it in, whisking it. You don't want to add it all at once.
Did you mix it up first? Okay. So you just stick your finger in it, mix it up, and Sam will have to do the same thing because this is all stuck. It's like cement on the bottom. So what activates the cornstarch, which is a thickening agent? What activates? Heat activates it. However, you can't just get cornstarch and make something thick by getting a box of cornstarch and sprinkling it in the sauce. What would happen? Do you know? The sprinkle of dry cornstarch turns into little lumps.
Right? Now I'm adding the cornstarch water.
So he is going to get it to sauce consistency, and when he gets it to sauce consistency, he's going to show you how to check for sauce consistency, which is the texture. We don't want it too thick, we don't want it too thin, and he's also going to tell you how to fix things if the sauce becomes too thick or too thin.
So right now, we're just looking to see if it comes back to stew. It's almost there, we're just going to let it reduce down a little bit.
So again, he's using the terminology reduce down. Right, so just bring it to a boil to more of the liquid evaporates to get it thick naturally. And it's important once you add cornstarch slurry that you cook that cornstarchiness out of there. That's why you always have to taste it. So you tell me something. If the filling doesn't taste good, you think the egg roll is going to taste good? What about if it was too thick or too thin? How could you fix it?
Well, if it was too thick, an easy way is just adding a little bit of pineapple juice so you keep the flavor. And if it was too thin, the easiest way to reduce it some more. If you needed to, if you had a big batch, you could just add some more cornstarch slurry, and that was picking it up really quick.
Okay, so we're going to show them a plate technique as well. So we're going to get a spoonful and put it on the plate. And then, so he should be able to just draw his finger through, and the sauce from both sides don't come together again. You see? That white line just stayed, that white plate is just right in the middle. That's a good consistency. It's not too runny. If it was runny, it would come back together again. Let's taste your filling. And see, he is adding more seasoning. And it's nice and thick, okay? That cornstarch makes it hold together. And now we're ready to wrap it. One person do the glue, and basically two fingers and a quick swipe, 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 swipe. Starting from here and moving down. Dakota is going to come around. Fill the disposable portion cup halfway. It's hot. You want to hold on to it. And then I want that filling towards the bottom corner. And then we are gonna just fold it up. So if you can just all the way to the middle, and then off to the sides, in. Okay, the sides in, and roll tight. And it's important that it's sealed completely. Just like remember the pot stickers, sealed completely. And then you have your floured sheet pan with your sweet and sour sauce on there. And the egg roll is going to be seam side down on the floured sheet pan. I'm going to continue on again. Roll up tight to the middle, fold in the sides, keep on rolling tight, floured sheet pan. Bottom, roll up tight, in the middle, like that, and we'll continue. Seems pretty easy enough, but I want you to do it like that, assembly line style.